Elon Musk, the billionaire founder of SpaceX, has revealed the company's latest plan to land humans on Mars. As it becomes clear that the best way for humanity to survive is to spread out into the solar system, SpaceX has accelerated its plans for a mission to Mars. The company has revealed mind-blowing details about how it aims to send astronauts on a perilous journey through deep space and set up a colony on the Martian surface. Let's take a closer look. Starship is the centerpiece of Musk's eventual plans to head to Mars. While the spacecraft remains in early testing, it is NASA's choice of craft to send Artemis astronauts to the moon no earlier than 2025. The testing program began with a smaller vehicle known as Star Hopper, which performed a series of tethered and untethered flight tests in 2019 and 2020. Then, SpaceX began testing a series of Starship vehicles in high-altitude flights, starting with a cautious hop test of SN5 in August 2020. One of the program's greatest challenges was executing flip maneuvers in midair, which led to the demise of several Starships before SN15 achieved a soft landing on May 5, 2021. Starship is designed to launch into orbit in deep space aboard Super Heavy, the 230-foot-tall booster that holds roughly 3.6 tons of liquid oxygen and methane in its propellant tanks. Like all of SpaceX's boosters, Super Heavy is planned to be reusable. It will feature 4 grid fins to assist in controlling the booster's descent. The fully stacked Super Heavy and Starship were put together on a launch pad for the first time in August 2021, standing 395 feet tall. That's more than 30 feet taller than NASA's massive Saturn V moon rocket. This Starship Super Heavy version is set to perform an orbital test in 2022, pending a delayed environmental review of the Federal Aviation Administration of SpaceX's launch facilities in Boca Chica, Texas. The public response to the review added more data points than FAA was anticipating, lengthening the process. SpaceX has customers from the private sector, military, and non-governmental entities which pay the company to launch cargo into space. Although SpaceX makes its money from launch services, the company is also focused on developing technology for future space exploration. And Musk's dreams of flying to Mars are undimmed. In 2011, he told delegates at the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics in San Diego that he planned to take people to Mars in 10 to 15 years. 3 years later, at the International Space Development Conference, he said the reusable rocket stage would be a step in getting to the Red Planet. In 2016, Musk unveiled his technological plan for Martian transport, which is a part of his plan to create a self-sustaining Red Planet colony in the next 50 to 100 years. The Interplanetary Transport System, as the rocket is called, is essentially a larger version of the Falcon 9. The spaceship, however, will be quite a bit larger than the Dragon, as it is slated to carry at least 100 people per flight. Musk followed up his announcement in 2017 by publishing a paper describing a future Red Planet city of 1 million people and providing more details about how the ITS would transport cargo and people. He further updated his Mars plans in September 2017 at an address in Australia. He didn't mention the ITS during the talk. Instead, he talked about a system called the Big Falcon Rocket. The spaceship that BFR will carry will be 157.5 feet tall and have 40 cabins for passengers, likely with a capacity of 100 people. Musk once again unveiled an update to his Mars plans in September 2019, renaming the first BFR to Starship MK1 and switching its outer coating from expensive carbon fiber to stainless steel. Starship continues to feature in Musk's Mars plans. In a February 2022 update, Musk said it may be possible to reach a launch rate of one Starship vehicle every 6 to 8 hours and one Super Heavy rocket every hour on missions that would send up to 150 tons of payload to orbit. Such a high launch rate is expected to bring down costs, making Mars settlements more financially feasible. Before Starship can launch to Mars, it will start off launching commercial satellites, followed by a crewed flight around the moon in 2023. Although SpaceX has not given a timeline for its first mission to Mars, SpaceX founder Elon Musk has said that the first Mars base could be up and running in 2028. And while Musk shared some eye-catching artist illustrations depicting what he called Mars Base Alpha as an intricate network of buildings and infrastructure, SpaceX's plans for the Red Planet are not quite that extensive. For its very first Mars missions, SpaceX will land at least 2 uncrewed cargo ships on the Red Planet before sending any humans there. Those cargo missions would bring supplies such as life support systems and power generators that the first astronauts on Mars will need when they set up camp. The first uncrewed Mars missions will also be tasked with confirming the presence of natural resources that can provide fuel for future two-way missions to the Red Planet. SpaceX wants to use water ice from the planet's surface and carbon dioxide from the Martian atmosphere to refuel starships on Mars, enabling the rockets to return to Earth. After those two first cargo missions, SpaceX will launch two crewed missions alongside two additional cargo-only flights to begin setting up a propellant production plant. At that plant, water and carbon dioxide will be converted into liquid methane and liquid oxygen, which fuel the rocket's engines. So, while SpaceX intends to set up a transportation system for humans and cargo traveling to the Red Planet, the company won't be building an entire Mars base on its own. Musk has laid out his vision to create a million-person colony on Mars, but to establish that colony, SpaceX will have to work together with NASA and the agency's international partners and other commercial space companies. Several companies have already begun designing concepts for Mars habitats and have proposed orbital outposts similar to NASA's Lunar Gateway, which could serve as a waypoint for Starship and reduce the amount of fuel needed for return trips to Earth. The first Martian city will open to regular people, not just scientists and researchers. People interested in moving to Mars could pay for their flight with a loan. Once there, people would be able to pay off the loan by working in anything, from iron foundries to pizzerias. Musk declared at a 2016 conference that there would be labor shortages for a long time. It's an idea that arguably bears resemblance to 19th century American company towns, where employees lived in a city owned by their employer. Especially in the early days, Mars may not have many choices for local employment, and you'll need to pay off that loan for your flight. This city would be free to govern itself on its own terms, as indicated by the Starlink Internet service terms and conditions released in October 2020. This appears to stand in contradiction to the 1967 Outer Space Treaty, which states that the launch origin country is responsible for subsequent space activities. David Anderman, who served as SpaceX's general counsel when the terms were released, suggests that the two documents may be set on a collision course. Musk estimated in 2019 that it would take around 1 million tons of cargo to build a self-sustaining city on Mars, assuming it costs $100,000 per ton to send cargo to Mars with the upcoming Starship. That would put a Mars city's price at around $100 billion. At the high end, Musk estimates it could cost around $10 trillion. SpaceX may not stop with just one city, however. Paul Wooster, the principal Mars development engineer for SpaceX, said at the 21st Annual International Mars Society Convention in August 2022 that SpaceX could build multiple cities. The idea would be to expand out and start not just with an outpost, but grow into a larger base, not just like there are in Antarctica, but a village, then a town, which grows into a city, and then multiple cities on Mars. Musk claimed in 2019 that a return ticket could cost around $500,000 initially, dropping to $100,000 over time. Musk's goal in 2016 was to reach a ticket price of around the median price of a house in the United States. That would suggest people could sell their houses to move to Mars. In 2017, Musk outlined an aspirational plan to send two cargo ships to Mars as early as 2022. It would then send four ships at the next closest approach, two crewed ships and two cargo ships in 2024. However, in March 2022, Musk suggested that a more likely date for humanity to witness the first humans on Mars would perhaps be 2029. It's also possible, however, that Musk was referencing the moon landing that took place in 1969, making it around 60 years between the two feats. Mars and Earth are at their closest around once every 26 months. The distance between the two at this time reduces to around 33.9 million miles. As SpaceX has yet to even host its first orbital flight with the Starship, it seems unlikely that it'll send the first cargo ships this year. If SpaceX adjusts its plans to a more realistic late 2020s deadline, it's perhaps more possible that Musk could indeed meet his goal. Recent reports have stated that NASA is interested in the Starship. However, the agency won't be fully committed to using it for its first human Mars missions until SpaceX has proven that the vehicle is ready for flight. NASA is also considering using its own space launch system Mega Rocket for Mars, but the development of that new rocket has faced years of delays. Starship itself is still in the design phase and is constantly updated with new designs. SpaceX has also begun testing a small Starship prototype called Starhopper. Experts suggest that SpaceX is still on track to meet its goals and send humans to Mars by the end of this decade. That time frame likely has something to do with the fact that the next suitable launch windows, based on the positions of Earth and Mars, will occur in 2024 and 2026. But while SpaceX is known for its ambitious ideas, Musk also has a history of offering ambitious timelines. Before we'll know when the first Starship missions can launch to Mars, SpaceX will first have to prove that the rockets can get there safely. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this one, which talks about SpaceX's 7-engine static fire test on a new Starship prototype. Do you think a colony on Mars is a good idea? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below.